if we read the Arabic and then we do the English from the text, then we get the comments from the Sheikh, we're going to have much longer, right? So I have no problem doing that, right? But it will take, because it will take time for me to also go back to translate it. So I don't know what you say, because the Sheikh will be explaining. So we can read the Arabic, and then the Sheikh will be talking about the content. And from that, we translate what he says. This will cut down on the time. Right? I want to hear the English speaking saying it's better, not the Arabic speaking, okay? I want to hear the English speaking say it's better, not the Arabic speaking, right? Because it's the right of the English audience to get the full thing out of it, right?
You have to be fair to everyone, so everyone is listening.
Yes.
It should be translated.
Yes. Completely. Yes, that's what I say too. But then it's up to the, you know, because it's the time too, right? And the time, and there will be a lot of texts that he will be reporting. So 3 days to finish, forget it. You need more than that. You need much more than that. So we can continue with this. We don't have to. أنا قاعد بستشيرهم بالقراءة لأنه حيطول عليهم الأمد يعني بالقراءة. هل نترجم أو لا نترجم؟ The Sheikh already agreed that we translate. يعني I read and then I translate, then he comments. But I'm just saying that it will take much more than this, and there are a lot of quotations that are coming, a lot of quotations from different books, right? So if we translate, read and translate each and every one, I'm just letting you know that it will take us more time. So I'm just consulting. He will be not commenting on each and everything. That's the point. He will be commenting on the main points. Yes, he will be mentioning that. Right? But then, if we don't do the full thing, yani that, yani, there is some, you know, it's lacking somehow. So I'm just consulting with you now. If the English speaking audience, they say we can do that, then we will just go with that, inshallah. We'll just read the Arabic and then we are sufficed with the comments of the Sheikh.
I would suggest translate
the Sheikh's comments. That's what there is this suggestion and there is the other one. I don't know. I mean, I heard from the English speaking audience, they're saying, yeah, let's do the comments. Because the comments will be sufficient. So that if that is okay with everybody, then that's what we will do.
You are missing a lot.
Right? You are missing a lot. طيب.
قال شيخ الإسلام بن تيمية رحمه الله تعالى.
طيب. قال شيخ الإسلام بن تيمية رحمه الله تعالى. ومحال مع تعليمهم كل شيء لهم فيه منفعة في الدين وإن دقت أن يترك تعليمهم ما يقولونه بألسنتهم ويعتقدونه بقلوبهم يعتقدونه في قلوبهم في ربهم ومعبودهم رب العالمين الذي معرفته غاية المعارف وعبادته أشرف المقاصد والوصول إليه غاية المطالب بل هذا خلاصة الدعوة النبوية وزبدة الرسالة الإلهية فكيف يتوهم من في قلبه أدنى مسكة من إيمان وحكمة أن لا يكون بيان هذا الباب قد وقع من الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم على غاية التمام ثم إذا كان قد وقع ذلك منه فمن المحال أن يكون خير أمته وأفضل قرونها قصروا في هذا الباب زائدين فيه أو ناقصين عنه ثم من المحال أيضا أن تكون القرون الفاضلة القرن الذي بعث فيهم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ثم الذين يلونهم كانوا غير عالمين وغير قائلين في هذا الباب بالحق المبين لأن ضد ذلك إما عدم العلم والقول، وإما اعتقاد نقيض الحق وقول خلاف الصدق، وكلاهما ممتنع. أما الأول فلأن من في قلبه أدنى حياة وطلب للعلم أو نهمة في العبادة يكون البحث عن هذا الباب والسؤال عنه ومعرفة الحق فيه أكبر مقاصده وأعظم مطالبه، أعني بيان ما ينبغي اعتقاده لا معرفة كيفية الرب وصفاته. وليست النفوس الصحيحة إلى شيء أشوق منها إلى معرفة هذا الأمر، وهذا أمر معلوم بالفطرة الوجدية، فكيف يتصور مع قيام هذا المقتضى الذي هو من أقوى المقتضيات أن يتخلف عنه مقتضاه في أولئك السادة في مجموع عصورهم؟ هذا لا يكاد يقع في أبلد الخلق وأشدهم إعراضا عن الله وأعظمهم انكبابا، أظن نعم. ممسوحة من الجنب، نعم. انكبابا على طلب الدنيا والغفلة عن ذكر الله تعالى، فكيف يقع من أولئك؟ وأما كونهم كانوا معتقدين فيه غير الحق أو قائليه، فهذا لا يعتقده مسلم ولا عاقل عرف حال القوم. ثم الكلام عنهم في هذا الباب أكثر من أن يمكن سطره في هذه الفتوى أو أضعافها، يعرف ذلك من طلبه وتتبعه. ولا يجوز أيضا أن يكون الخالفون أعلم من السالفين، كما قد يقوله بعض الأغبياء ممن لم يقدر قدر السلف، بل ولا عرف الله ورسوله والمؤمنين به حقيقة المعرفة المأمور بها، من أن طريقة السلف أسلم وطريقة الخلف أعلم وأحكم. وإن كانت هذه العبارة إذا صدرت من بعض العلماء قد يعنى بها معنى صحيحا، فإن هؤلاء المبتدعة الذين يفضلون طريقة الخلف من المتفلسفة ومن حذا حذوهم على طريقة السلف إنما أتوا من حيث ظنوا أن طريقة السلف هي مجرد الإيمان بألفاظ القرآن والحديث من غير فقه، لذلك بمنزلة الأميين الذين قال الله فيهم ومنهم أميون لا يعلمون الكتاب إلا أماني، وأن طريقة الخلف هي استخراج معاني النصوص المصروفة عن حقائقها بأنواع المجازات وغرائب اللغات.
حسبك، استرجم لهم الآن.
أين؟
لأنه انتهى المعنى.
طيب
ترجم لهم وأنا ألخص ما قرأت شرحا.
طيب إن شاء الله
من حيث بدأت.
أين؟ Now we try to translate this. It's a long passage, as you have heard. He said it is impossible. He's now connecting the speech with him giving an example that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم taught the companions everything, including how to relieve themselves, how to use the etiquettes of using the washroom. He said, now it is impossible. Along with him teaching them everything that there is benefit for them in the religion, even if it is very small and minute, it is impossible that he would leave teaching them what they should say with their tongues and what they should believe in their hearts regarding their Lord and the one they are worshiping, the Lord of the worlds, the one who's knowing him is the most important pieces of knowledge. Worshipping him is the most noble objective, and reaching him is the most important thing that people request or require. Rather, this is, yani worshipping him, this is the knowing Allah Azza wa Jalla and worshipping him. This is the summary of the prophetic call. This is the root of the godly message. So how is it that one who has the smallest piece of iman and wisdom, how can he imagine in his heart that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam wouldn't have clarified this this type of knowledge, that is the knowledge of Allah's names and attributes, right? How is it that he wouldn't be clarifying this matter in a way that is complete and perfect? Then if this has happened from him, if he clarified, that is, if the Messenger ﷺ clarified this issue, then it is impossible for the best of his nation and the best of the centuries that they would be deficient in this regard, adding to it or diminishing of it. Then it is also impossible that the first noble generations, the generation in which the Messenger ﷺ was sent in, those who are after them, it is impossible for them that they be not knowledgeable and not saying regarding this with the truth, with the clear truth. Because the opposite of that is either them not knowing and not making a statement about the names and attributes of the Allah, that is, or it is believing the opposite of the truth and making a statement that other than the truth, and both of them are impossible. As for the first one, that is because the one who has in his heart the least of life and the least of seeking knowledge or yearning to worship Allah Azza wa Jal, it will be the one who has the least of that searching for this, yani knowing Allah Azza wa Jal, searching for this and asking about it and knowing the truth regarding it, it will be his most important or the greatest objective of his. Clarifying what one should believe, not knowing the how of the attribute of the Lord are. And the sound souls, they are most eager to knowing this matter, and most eager to knowing this matter. And this is a matter that is known with the human nature. So how is it then that it can be imagined, along with this this strong drive, which is the one of the strongest drives? How is it that it will not lead to the result? How is it that it will not lead to the result? Speaking about those leaders in all of these, the leaders and the imams in all of these generations, right? How is it that they will not be talking about explaining the attributes of Allah? He said this almost cannot happen in even the most foolish people, and those who are the most in terms of turning away from Allah Azza wa Jal, and the most in terms of getting involved in seeking the worldly pleasures and having negligence from the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal. So those who are like this, they wouldn't do that. So how about the best generations? It will not happen from them. As for them, as for the case, if it is said that they did not believe the truth regarding that, or not making a statement, a truth statement regarding that, then this is something that no Muslim and no intellectual person who knows the condition of the people of that time, yani the companions, the second generation and the third generation, who know the case or the condition of those noble generations, then also, the Sheikh said, also their speech regarding that, regarding the names and attributes of Allah, is more than can be recorded in this fatwa, or multitudes of the size of this fatwa, meaning they spoke a lot in this regard. The one who seeks that and pursues it, then he will know it. And it is not allowable also that the later generations, they would be more knowledgeable than those who preceded them, like some foolish people who did not know the value and status of the pious predecessors, who don't even know Allah and His Messenger and those who believe in Him, the real knowledge. The one who says the way of the predecessors is safer, but the way of the later generation is more knowledgeable and more wise. The Sheikh said that even though this statement, if it came from some of the scholars, maybe they mean by it a sound meaning. Those innovators who give preference to the way of the later generations of the philosophers and those who are like them, they prefer it over the way of the pious predecessors. They only fall short from the aspect that they thought that the way of the Salaf, the way of the pious predecessors, is just simply believing in the words of the Quran and the Hadith without having understanding in that. This is like the status of the unlettered, the ones that Allah said about them, and amongst them are those who are unlettered. They do not know of the book except to recite it. And that the way of the later generations is to extract the meanings of the texts, the meanings that are interpreted other than their or given other than their real meanings. They're given figurative meanings, and they are using the most strange words in the language or meanings in the language to explain them. So this corrupt thought, this corrupt imagination necessitated that statement, which is the way of the pious predecessors is safer, the way of the later generation is more knowledgeable, more wise. This corrupt thought has necessitated that statement, which the gist of it, what it contains, is to turn, throw Islam behind his back. And they lied against the way of the pious predecessors, and they have been misguided in terms of them attributing correctness to the way of the later generations. So they combined between ignorance of the way of the pious predecessors by lying against them, and they combined with that the ignorance and misguidance by attributing correctness and soundness to the way of the later generations. This is now an example of what will happen if we go through the translation, right? I'm not aware that there is an English translation of this. Otherwise, the easiest thing is while we are reading the Arabic, you will be reading the English on your own. But there isn't a translation, right? So that's what we are doing, inshallah. Yalla, bismillah, tafaddal ya Sheikh.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. كما سمعتم من فضيلة الشيخ.
As you heard, inshallah.
والترجمة بحد ذاتها شرح.
And the explanation, the translation by itself is explanation.
ومن نعمة الله تبارك وتعالى.
From the favor of Allah, the bounty of Allah upon us.
أنه ما أرسل من رسول.
That he didn't send a messenger.
إلا بلسان قومه.
Except that he sent him with the tongue or the language of his people.
ليبين لهم ما يتقون.
So that he will clarify to them what they should protect themselves from.
ومن نعمة الله تبارك وتعالى الأخرى.
And from the bounties of Allah also.
وهي نعمة خاصة.
And this is a special bounty.
أن أرسل الله تبارك وتعالى.
That Allah عز وجل sent.
محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
بلسان عربي مبين.
With a clear Arabic tongue.
يسع هذا اللسان جميع اللغات.
This tongue houses all kinds of languages.
ولا تسعه اللغات كلها.
And the other languages, all of them combined together, cannot house this Quran.
ولذلك كان من فضل الله تبارك وتعالى على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى أمته.
This is why from the bounty of Allah سبحانه وتعالى upon Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and his ummah.
أنه علمه هذه اللغة.
That he taught him this language.
أي اللغة العربية.
Meaning the Arabic language.
ففضيلة الشيخ شرح لكم.
So it was explained to you or translated to you.
من خلال الترجمة.
From through the translation.
وأما أنا فسوف أوضح بعض النقاط.
As for myself, I will clarify some of the points.
لأتمم ما بدأه الشيخ.
So that I will complement or complete what the translation started with.
وهذا في كتابي أصلاً.
And this in my book actually.
نهاية المجلس الأول.
This is the end of the first sitting.
نعم.
What we have done. The end of the first sitting.
من 22 مجلساً.
That is one out of 22 sittings.
وشرحي في هامش الكتاب واضح بين.
My explanation is actually in the margins of the book.
وخلاصته ما يلي.
And the summary of that is what you will hear.
اعتقاد المتأخرين.
The belief of the later generation.
أن السلف.
Is that the pious predecessors.
من أصحاب القرون الثلاثة الأولى.
Of the first three generations.
الذين شهد لهم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بالخيرية.
That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم testified to them that they are the best.
بقوله خير الناس قرني.
By him saying the best of the people are my generation.
ثم الذين يلونهم.
Then those who come after them.
ثم الذين يلونهم.
Then those who come after them.
اعتقد المتأخرون.
The later generations believed.
من أهل البدع.
From the people of innovation that is.
أن هؤلاء المتقدمين من السلف.
That the early pious predecessors.
الأخيار.
The best of the nation.
ليس عندهم العلم.
That they do not have knowledge.
بصفات الله.
Of the attributes of Allah.
أو أنهم كانوا لا يعتقدون بصفات الله.
Or that they used not to believe in the attributes of Allah.
ما اعتقده المتأخرون.
As what the later generations believe.
من اعتقاد باطل.
Of the false beliefs that the later generations used to have.
بصفات الله تبارك وتعالى.
About the attributes of Allah.
حتى قال بعض أهل العلم.
To a point that some people of knowledge they said.
بمعنى صحيح.
With a sound meaning.
علم السلفي أو السلف إيش العبارة؟
طريقة السلف.
طريقة السلف أعلم.
The way of the salaf is more knowledgeable.
وطريقة الخلف أعلم وأحكم.
The way of the salaf أسلم شيخنا. The way of the salaf is safer, but the way of the later generations that is about the attributes of Allah in understanding the attributes of Allah is more knowledgeable and more wise.
وأراد بهذا بهذه العبارة.
What they meant by this statement.
معنى صحيح.
A sound meaning.
يبين فيه علم السلف.
Trying to clarify regarding that the knowledge of the pious predecessors.
وسلامة.
And also that they're safe.
وحكمة الخلف. الخلف الذي أريد أن أتمم عنه.
طيب the knowledge of the knowledge and the wisdom of the later generations.
الخلف الذي يريده هذا هؤلاء العلماء الذين قالوا هذه العبارة.
The later generations that are meant by those scholars who mentioned this statement.
الذين كانوا على خطى السلف.
Those who were upon the same path as the pious predecessors.
ولكن اختلفوا عنهم من حيث العصور.
But they differed from them in terms of time and age.
فمن حيث المنهج هم على منهجهم.
In the sense of the in terms of manhaj methodology, they are upon the same methodology.
ومن حيث العصور فهم متأخرون.
As for the generation, then they are of a later time.
فعبارتهم هذه التي قالوها.
So their statement that they made.
أعدها. بالعربية.
نعم. نقرأها.
نقرأها.
نقرأها من الكتاب. طريقة السلف أسلم وطريقة الخلف أعلم وأحكم.
نعم. هذه.
The way of the pious predecessors is safer, and the way of the later generation is more knowledgeable and more wise.
نعم. فالعلماء الربانيون.
The lordly scholars.
أرادوا أنهم يجمعوا بين طريقة السلف
They wanted to combine between the way of the pious predecessors
في تفويض كيفية صفات الله تبارك وتعالى
regarding the attributes of Allah عز وجل that they refer the knowledge of the how of the attributes of Allah to Allah عز وجل
وهي طريقة سليمة
and this is a sound way
وطريقة الخلف
and the way of the later generation
في معرفة صفات الله
in terms of knowing the names the attributes of Allah
أي في معرفة معاني الألفاظ
meaning to know the meaning of the words
التي دلت على صفات الله
which prove the attributes of Allah
فجمعوا بين سلامة تفويض الكيفية
so they combined between the safety in terms of referring the knowing of how the attributes of Allah to Allah
والعلم بمعاني الألفاظ
and the knowledge of the meanings of the words
الدالة على صفات الله تبارك وتعالى
which prove the attributes of Allah سبحانه وتعالى
وهذا الفرق
and this difference
بين العلماء الربانيين من الخلف
between the lordly scholars of the later generation
وبين المبتدعة
And this is the difference between them and the innovators.
الذين لم يعرفوا معاني الألفاظ الدالة على صفات الله.
Those who did not know the meanings of the words that prove the name, the attributes of Allah.
فكان أهل السنة.
So the people of the Sunnah.
في المصطلح القديم.
In the old terminology.
على ثلاثة أوجه.
Upon three types.
وجه عرف الحق
the first people they knew the truth
وهم السلف
they are the pious predecessors
الذين قالوا هذه العبارة
those who made this statement
طريقة السلف أسلم
the way of the pious predecessors is safer
وطريقة الخلف أعلم وأحكم
the way of the later generations is more knowledgeable more wise
والوجه الثاني أو الطائفة الثانية
the second group or the second aspect
قالوا بأن السلف
they said that the pious predecessors
سمعوا وقالوا
they heard and they said
في صفات الله تبارك وتعالى
regarding the attributes of Allah سبحانه وتعالى
دون علم بمعانيها
without knowing the meanings
وهو الذي عبروا عنه
and this is what they expressed
بتفويض الكيفية
referring the knowledge of the how of the attributes of Allah
والمعنى
and the meaning they refer that the knowledge of the how of the attribute and also the meaning of the attribute they refer it to Allah
فكانوا كأنهم أميين
so then it's as if they were unlettered
لا يعلمون من المعاني شيئا
they don't know anything of the meanings
وطائفة أخرى
Like uneducated, that is, and a third group, another group,
خالفتهم.
They went against them.
فجاءوا إلى هذه الألفاظ.
They came to these words.
في صفات الله.
Regarding the attributes of Allah.
وتسلطوا عليها بمعان.
And they attacked and they assigned meanings to them.
معاني غير صحيحة.
They assigned meanings that are incorrect to these words.
بينما السلف
while the early predecessors
جمعوا الحق في الطريقتين الأخريين
they combined the truth in the other two ways
وتركوا الباطل من الطريقتين الأخريين
and they left the falsehood in the other two ways
يعني بعبارة أخرى
in other words
طائفة كان عندها حق وباطل من جهة
one group it has some truth and some falsehood
والطائفة الأخرى عندها حق وباطل من جهة.
The other one it had also some truth and some falsehood in another regard.
السلف أخذوا الحق الذي عند هؤلاء.
The pious predecessors they took what is true with the first group.
والحق الذي عند هؤلاء.
And the what is true with that the second group has.
وتركوا الباطل عند الفئتين.
And they left the falsehood from the two groups.
فكانت طريقتهم في فهم النصوص
so their way in understanding the texts
أعني بذلك نصوص الصفات
I mean the texts regarding the attributes of Allah
تفويض الكيفية لله تبارك وتعالى الذي لا يعلمها إلا هو.
Referring the knowledge of the how of the attribute of Allah, referring it to Allah, that nobody knows the how of the attribute of Allah except Allah.
وبيان المعاني التي تدل عليها هذه الألفاظ.
And clarifying the meanings that these words prove.
أي المعاني الصحيحة.
Meaning the correct meanings of the words.
فجمعوا بين السلامة.
So they combine between safety
من خلال التفويض
by referring the how of the attribute to Allah
وبين العلم من خلال المعاني
and they combined with that also the knowledge by knowing the meanings of these words
فكانوا بذلك حكماء
so this way they are wise
وعندما نتكلم عن هذه الصفات بأمثلة
When we talk about these attributes with examples,
سيتبين لنا سلامة وعلم وحكمة منهج السلف.
It will become clear to us the safety, the knowledge, and the wisdom that is in the way of the pious predecessors.
وسأستبق المجالس القادمة ببيان صفة كمثال.
And I will speak ahead of the next sittings with mentioning one example.
صفة الاستواء التي بدأ السائل بالسؤال عنها.
The attribute of Allah rising over the throne that the questioner started asking about it.
لفظة الاستواء.
The word استواء.
دللت على عدة معاني في القرآن.
It proved many meanings in the Quran.
فنجدها في قوله الرحمن على العرش استوى.
We find it in the statement of Allah, the ever merciful rose over the throne.
تدل بمعنى غير معنى قوله عز وجل
it has a meaning there other than the meaning in the statement of Allah عز وجل
ثم استوى على العرش
then he rose over the throne
غير معنى قوله
other than the meaning of the statement of Allah
ثم استوى إلى السماء
then he rose up to the sky
وفي غير ما يتعلق بالله تبارك وتعالى
when it came up referring to other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala
في وصف بعض مخلوقاته
describing some of the created things that Allah created
أنها استوت
that they established themselves or rose over something
فنجد في قوله عز وجل عن الأنبياء أو عن بعض الأنبياء والرسل
We find the statement of Allah Azza wa Jalla about some of the prophets and messengers.
فلما بلغ أشده واستوى.
And when he grew mature in age and became perfect or complete.
فهذه لفظة استوى.
This is the word استوى appearing here.
وجدناها في صفات الله.
We found it referring to the attributes of Allah.
الرحمن على العرش استوى.
In reference to the attribute of Allah, ثم ever merciful rose over the throne.
ثم استوى على العرش.
Then he rose over the throne.
ثم استوى إلى السماء.
Then he rose to the heaven, the sky.
ووصف بعض بعض خلقه غير الأنبياء.
And Allah described some of his creation other than the prophets.
من عامة الناس.
From the general people, general folks.
فقال
Allah said
عن الدواب
about the riding animals
لتستووا على ظهوره
so that you will establish yourselves the humans that is you establish yourselves on their backs the riding animal that is
فلفظة الاستواء هنا
so the word استواء here
في غير لفظة بلغ أشده واستوى.
This the meaning of it here is other than the in reference to that prophet. استوى meaning he became perfect and complete.
وقال عن سفينة نوح.
Also Allah said about the ark of Noah.
ثم استوت على الجودي.
Then it established on the جودي.
إذن لفظة استوى
then the word استوى itself
تجدها في القرآن في عدة مواضع
You find it in the Quran in different places.
في كل موضع لها معنى غير الموضع غير المعنى الآخر.
The word itself, you find different meanings for it in every place. It's different from the other place.
فجاء الطائفة.
So a group came.
ممن ينتسبون إلى السنة.
Who attribute themselves to the Sunnah.
فجعلوا هذه المعاني الستة التي ذكرناها.
So they made all of these meanings, the six meanings that we mentioned.
معنى واحدا.
They made them just one meaning.
وهذا خطأ.
And this is a mistake.
وجاء الطائفة أخرى.
There is another group that came.
حرفت معاني هذه المعاني الستة.
They distorted and twisted the meanings of those six meanings.
إلى معان غير صحيحة.
To meanings that are incorrect.
بينما السلف.
While the pious predecessors
جعلوا لكل لفظة
they gave every word
من هذه الألفاظ الستة
of these six words
معنى
they gave it a meaning
يناسبها في سياق وسباق النص
that is suitable to the context where it is mentioned.
فمعنى الاستواء في قوله عز وجل الرحمن على العرش استوى.
The meaning of استوى in الرحمن على العرش استوى, the ever merciful rose over the throne.
بمعنى على وارتفع.
Meaning he is above it and he rose over it.
ومعنى قوله عز وجل ثم استوى على العرش.
The meaning of the statement ثم استوى على العرش.
أنه بعد الخلق بعد ما خلق سبحانه وتعالى.
That he سبحانه وتعالى after created he created the creation.
استقر على العرش.
He established himself on the throne.
وأنه عندما خلق السماء وخلق المخلوقات.
And that when he created the creation.
قصد إلى السماء.
He turned with intent.
ثم استوى إلى السماء وهي دخان.
Then he turned with intent to the sky when it was smoke.
فكل لفظ في هذه الآيات الثلاث.
So every wording in these three verses
دل على معنى
it proved a meaning
غير المعنى الآخر
other than the other meaning in the other ayat.
وكلها صفات لله تبارك وتعالى.
All of these are attributes for Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
ولما ذكر هذه اللفظة في مخلوقاته
when Allah mentioned this wording regarding pertaining or in reference to his creation
بيّن لكل لفظة معنى غير المعاني السابقة.
He clarified that for each wording there is a meaning other than the other meanings
وغير المعاني اللاحقة
and other than the former and the subsequent meaning.
فلما قال عن نبيه الذي وصفه بلغ أشده واستوى.
So when Allah said about his prophet that he reached the old age of maturity and he became complete in personality.
أي بلغ الكمال الإنساني.
Meaning he reached the human perfection.
ولما ذكر لتستوى على ظهوره.
And when he mentioned that when you going to be establishing yourself over the riding animals
أي تستقر وترتاح
meaning you establish yourself and you comfort yourself or be comfortable on top of the riding animals.
ولما ذكر عن السفينة ثم استوت على الجودي
and when he mentioned about the ark of Noah that it got on the mountain or was established on the mountain
أي انتهت من حالة طفاوة على الماء
meaning that the ark of Noah is no more sailing and it got anchored
ووصلت إلى اليابسة
it got anchored on the land
إذن المعاني
then the meanings
لا يجوز لنا أن نجعلها معنى واحدا كما جعلها إحدى تلك الطوائف.
It's not allowed to make it just one meaning like one of these groups that were mentioned. They made all of these to be just one meaning.
ولا يجوز لنا أيضا.
It is not allowed for us also.
أن نحرف معانيها.
That we should. It is not allowed to distort and to twist its meanings.
عن المعاني التي جاءت بها.
From the meanings that they have come with.
في سياق القرآن.
In the context, in the Quranic context.
فالطائفة الثالثة قالت استوى بمعنى استولى.
So the third group, they said that the word استوى, it means that he reigned and took control of.
وهذه المعاني الستة التي ذكرناها
and these six different meanings that we mentioned
ليس فيها أي معنى من معاني الاستيلاء
none of the meanings that we mentioned has this meaning of taking control and to reign over
لأن
full control
لأن الاستيلاء يقتضي
that is because taking full control it necessitates
الأخذ والمنازعة
that one is fighting and battling with another one
ولذلك استدلوا بهذا المعنى ببيت شاعر
this is why when they gave this meaning to the word استوى they had to use the poetry a line of poetry from one of the poets
فقالوا استوى بشر على العراق
who said that بشر took reign or took control استوى over العراق
بغير دم بغير سيف ولا دم مهراق
he took control over Iraq without sword and without shedding blood
وبشر المقصود به بشر بن مروان أخو عبد الملك بن مروان
بشر what is meant by it بشر بن مروان the brother of عبد الملك
وهذا كان بعد سنة 65 من الهجرة
This is after the year 65 هجرة
أي بعد القرن الأول الذين عرفوا المعاني الصحيحة
Meaning after the first generation who knew the correct meanings of the Arabic words
فجاءوا بمعنى محرف
So they came up with a twisted distorted meaning
فزادوا على الكلمة حرفا
So they added to the word a letter
استوى استولى
So instead of استوى which means to rise over or to be above they made it استولى they added the letter لام which means to control and to take to rule and to reign
فزادوا حرفا واحدا
So they added just one letter استوى استولى they added the لام
حرف المعنى
But then they twisted and they distorted the meaning completely.
إلى معنى فاسد.
They gave it a corrupt meaning.
وهي طريقة يهودية في الأصل.
And this is a Jewish way in principle.
قال الله عز وجل قولوا في قال لهم قولوا حطة.
That Allah سبحانه وتعالى ordered the Jews to say حطة. We are asking you to basically abolish to place down and abolish to destroy our sins.
فقالوا حنطة.
Rather they said instead of حطة we ask you to absolve us from our sins. They said حنطة. They added the noon in the middle so it became like a grain of wheat.
فزادوا حرفا.
So they added the letter noon.
حرفوا المعنى عن حقيقته.
So they twisted and distorted the meaning from it the original meaning.
وبهذا ضلت هذه الطائفة ضلال اليهود.
And in this way, this group of deviant, they deviated in the same way the Jews got deviated.
بينما السلف رضي الله تعالى عنهم.
While the pious predecessors, may Allah be pleased with them.
فأبقوا هذه الألفاظ كما هي.
They left those words as they are.
بمعانيها الصحيحة التي ذكرناها
and with their correct meanings which we have mentioned
ولكن بكيفيتها
but in terms of the how of the attribute of Allah
أوكلوا علمها إلى الله تبارك
they
وتعالى
they left the knowledge of that they referred the knowledge of the how the attribute of Allah is they referred the knowledge of that to Allah عز وجل
الذي لا يعلم حقيقة كيفيتها إلا هو
The one whom there is no one that knows the how of the attributes of Allah except He subhanahu wa ta'ala.
أرجو أن يكون هذا المثال
I hope that this example
موضحا لهذه المناهج
clarifying to these different methodologies.
نعم هو أنا في العادة وضعت أسئلة كنت أناقش فيها الإخوة لأرى أين وصلوا في الفهم والاستيعاب لكن لا أريد أن أدخل في هذه الأسئلة نبدأ إن شاء الله في المجلس الثاني
إن شاء الله The Sheikh said I usually put at the end of every مجلس I put few questions to see how the audience how much they understand from what I said but then there is no need to do that now let's go to the second sitting قال شيخ الإسلام بن تيمية رحمه الله تعالى وسبب ذلك اعتقادهم أنه ليس في نفس الأمر صفة دلت عليها هذه النصوص للشبهات الفاسدة التي شاركوا فيها إخوانهم من الكافرين فلما اعتقدوا انتفاء الصفات في نفس الأمر وكان مع ذلك لابد للنصوص من معنى، بقوا مترددين بين الإيمان باللفظ وتفويض المعنى، وهي التي يسمونها طريقة السلف، وبين صرف اللفظ إلى معان بنوع تكلف، وهي التي يسمونها طريقة الخلف. فصار هذا الباطل مركبا من فساد العقل والكفر بالسمع، فإن النفي إنما اعتمدوا فيه على أمور عقلية ظنوها بينات وهي شبهات، والسمع حرفوا فيه الكلام عن مواضعه. فلما ابتنى أمرهم فلما ابتنى أمرهم على هاتين المقدمتين الكفريتين الكاذبتين، كانت النتيجة استجهال السابقين الأولين واستبلاههم، واعتقاد أنهم كانوا قوما أميين بمنزلة الصالحين من العامة، لم يتبحروا في حقائق العلم بالله، ولم يتفطنوا لدقائق العلم الإلهي، وأن الخلف الفضلاء حازوا قصب السبق في هذا كله. ثم هذا القول إذا تدبره الإنسان وجده في غاية الجهالة، بل في غاية الضلالة. كيف يكون هؤلاء المتأخرون لا سيما والإشارة بالخلف إلى ضرب من المتكلمين بالخلف إلى ضرب من المتكلمين الذين كثر في باب الدين اضطرابهم،
لأن عندنا خلف وخلف.
نعم. وغلظ عن معرفة الله حجابهم، وأخبر الواقف على نهايات إقدامهم بما انتهى إليه من مرامهم، حيث يقول: لعمري لقد طفت المعاهد كلها وسيرت طرفي بين تلك المعالم، فلم أرى إلا واضعا كف حائر على ذقن أو قارعا سن نادم. وأقروا على نفوسهم بما قالوه متمثلين به أو منشئين له فيما صنفوه من كتبهم، كقول بعض رؤسائهم: نهاية إقدام العقول عقال، وأكثر سعي العالمين ضلال، وأرواحنا في وحشة من جسومنا، وغاية دنيانا أذى ووبال، ولم نستفد من بحثنا طول عمرنا سوى أن جمعنا فيه قيل وقالوا. لقد تأملت الطرق الكلامية والمناهج الفلسفية، فما رأيتها تشفي غليلا ولا تروي عليلا ولا تروي غليلا، ورأيت أقرب الطرق طريقة القرآن، أقرأ في الإثبات الرحمن على العرش استوى إليه يصعد الكريم الطيب، وأقرأ في النفي ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير ولا يحيطون به علما، ومن جرب مثل تجربتي عرف مثل معرفتي. انتهى. نقف هنا ولا نكمل شيخ؟
لا، ترجم ثم أنا أبين من الذي قال وماذا قال.
طيب إن شاء الله. شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله says: and the reason behind that is them believing that there is no in reality there is no attribute that these texts from the Quran has that these texts from the Quran are proving. That is because of the corrupt misconceptions which they are partners in this to their brothers of the disbelievers. So when they believe that the attributes of Allah are negated in reality, and along with that, those texts in the Quran, they must have some sort of a meaning, they remained shaky, they remained in doubt between believing in the wording and referring the meaning to Allah. And this is what they are calling the way of the Salaf. And between the other way, they are shaky between this and the other way, and that is to give the wording another meaning with some sort of going overboard or going out of their way in explaining away, yani giving the word a meaning that is basically far away from the true meaning. And this is what they call the way of the later generation. So this falsehood have been assembled between two things: corrupt intellect and disbelief in the reports in the Quran and the Sunnah. So this negation, because this negation, they only depended in it upon matters that are intellectual matters. They thought that they are clarifications while they are only misconceptions. And the sam', what comes from the Quran and the Sunnah, they twisted the wording in it from its places. They distorted their meanings. So when their affair has been built upon these two disbelieving, most lying introductions, then the result was that they viewed the early predecessors, they viewed them to be ignorant, and they viewed them to be also foolish. And they believed that they used to be people who are unlettered, uneducated. They have the status of pious people from the general folks who did not have a lot of knowledge, real knowledge about Allah Azza wa Jal, and they were not sharp enough to pick the pieces of knowledge about God subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that those people who came later on, the noble people of the later generations, they outraced them and they pioneered them and they beat them in this regard, in knowing Allah's attributes. So then the Sheikh says, then this statement that they said, if the human being reflects upon it, he will find it in extreme, there is extreme ignorance in it. Rather, there is even extreme misguidance in it. Because how is it that those who came later on, especially when they are by those later generations, they are referring to the philosophers. They are referring to the philosophers who, in terms of the religion, those philosophers, their confusion, their confusion and their mix-up is a lot, and their knowledge of Allah is they are barred from knowing Allah, the true knowledge. And the one who saw the books that they have authored and the statements that they have made, he will find that one of them, one of their the big philosophers now of the later generations that they are referring to as they understand better, he said about himself, he said about himself that he has toured all different types of toured all kinds of places, and he has looked with his eyes to different parts of the world, and he was reflecting and pondering and all of that. He said about himself, after looking at the universe, the situation of many people in the universe, he said, I have not seen amongst them except one who places the palm of a confused person on his chin, or another one who is basically biting on his tongue out of regret, that is, right? And this is the poetry that he says about himself. This is like the people who are supposed to have understanding, better than the early generations, better than the companions. The Sheikh said, they have testified against themselves with what they said, whether they are using lines of poetry to using it from others, or they are the ones who are initiating those lines of poetry in the books that they have authored, like one of their chiefs. One of their chiefs, he said in his book that the end of those, the embarking of the intellectual, those intellectual ideas and philosophy that he was very much immersed into, he said that the end of this intellectual battle, if you want to call it, the end of it is like being tied up, عقال, being tied up, يعني having, reaching a knot that you cannot untie. Right? You are reaching a knot, right? And the most of the labor of the people in the world most of their labor is going to waste. It's just deviating. Dalal. He said, our souls are alienated from our bodies, and the utmost end of our worldly life is harm and destruction. Adhan wa wabal. He said, we did not benefit from our researches all of our lives, except that we gathered together. They said, and they said. They said by so-and-so, and other ones said so-and-so. Then he says, the same person, one of their chiefs, he says, and the sheikh said that he will mention who he is and what he said and which book he said that. He said, I have considered the philosophicals or the rhetorical philosophical ways and the philosophical methodologies. I did not see them that they heal the sickness, and they do not quench the thirst. I have seen the closest of the ways is the way of the Quran. I recite in affirming, that is the attributes of Allah, the ever merciful rose over the throne, up unto him rise the good words. And I recite in negation, there is nothing like him, and he is all hearing, all seeing. And I recite also, he says, they do not encompass him, the humans, they do not encompass him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in terms of knowledge. Then he said, the one who experienced the same experience as mine, then he will have the knowledge, the exact knowledge as mine, right? The one who tried the same, he will get the same knowledge as mine. You know, you go through philosophy very deep and you don't get anything out of that. تفضل يا شيخ.
نعم. الحقيقة أيها الإخوة.
The reality, my brothers.
أن بيان شيخ الإسلام رحمه الله تعالى.
That the clarification of شيخ الإسلام, may Allah have mercy on him.
لحال هاتين الطائفتين.
To the situation of these two groups of people,
اللتين نسبتا إلى السنة,
those two groups of people that are attributed to the Sunnah,
وهما باختصار,
and they are in summary,
المفوضة,
the group called المفوضة,
والمؤولة,
and the group called المؤولة.
وبعبارة أخرى,
in other words,
الماتريدية وهم المفوضة.
الماتريدية, these are the ones we call المفوضة.
والأشاعرة وهم المؤولة.
The other group called الأشاعرة and they are المؤولة.
والأصح أن نقول,
what is more correct is to say,
المحرفة.
About the second group, المحرفة, the distorters.
فطائفة المفوضة وهي,
called المفوضة,
وهي إلى التعطيل أقرب.
And they are closer to denying the attributes of Allah.
والمؤولة وهي إلى التحريف أقرب.
And the مؤولة, which are closer to the distorting of the attributes of Allah.
ونجد هذه المصطلحات التي ذكرتها.
And we find these terminologies that I mentioned.
في كثير من كتب.
In many of the books.
الاعتقاد.
The books of beliefs.
هؤلاء.
They are. These people are.
ظنوا.
They thought. أنا شيخنا لم أشرح لا المفوضة ولا المؤولة. نعم. أظن أنتم ستشرحونها. طيب أنا ذكرتها كما هي.
أنا أعطيت المثال الأول في الاستواء عليهم. الآن أنا أقول ما قاله شيخ الإسلام هنا, وإن لم يسمهم بالأسماء التي ينتسبون إليها, إنما وصفهم بغير تسمية.
The Sheikh, شيخ الإسلام, he only described them. He did not name them really.
وصف ولم يسمي.
So he described but he did not name these groups.
أنا الآن أصف وأسمي.
Now I am describing and I am naming them.
فهؤلاء زعموا,
those they claimed,
أن طريقتهم,
that their way,
في التفويض,
In terms of tafweed, which is referring, they claim referring the meanings of the attributes to Allah.
وإن شئت أن تقول بالتعطيل, تعطيل المعاني.
And if you want, you can say actually their denial of the meanings of the words of the Quran that prove the attributes of Allah.
وأولئك الذين حرفوا.
And on the other side, those who distorted the meanings.
وإن شئت عفوا قلت الذين أولوا وإن شئت فقل الذين حرفوا.
And those who basically made what is called تأويل, which is giving the words figurative meanings. And if you want, really, you can call them those who distorted the meanings.
بعد أن خاضوا في هذه التي يسمونها علوم التفويض والتأويل.
They, after they have indulged themselves in these branches of knowledge, which they call تفويض and they call تأويل.
وهم ليسوا خلفا.
And they are not really successors.
بفتح اللام.
With فتحة on the lam, خلف.
بل هم خلف.
Rather, they are خلف with a سكون. The word خلف with a فتحة means successor.
بتسكين اللام.
خلف with a سكون on the lam, it means bad people.
فأنا أوضح المعنى.
So now I'm clarifying the meaning. الشيخ said.
أنا خلفت في الأردن أبنائي وتلاميذي.
The word خلف. Here I left behind, he said, in Jordan. I left behind my family, my children.
وهم على منهجي الآن.
They are upon the same methodology as mine, but I left them behind.
لم يغيروا ولم يبدلوا.
They did not change. They did not do any change to the methodology.
ووضعت خلفي.
And I placed behind me
عباءتي.
خلف my cloak.
عباءتي.
Cloak. عباءتي.
نعم. ويمكن أن تبقى مكانها.
Maybe it will stay in its place.
فهي لا تعقل.
So my cloak has no mind, no intellect.
ولا توصف بمدح.
And cannot be praised.
بينما الخلف يوصف بالمدح.
Rather, الخلف, the successor, right, may be praised, may be praiseworthy.
قالت السيدة عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها.
عائشة رضي الله عنها said.
ومضى الذين أحبهم.
Those whom I love, they passed away.
وبقيت في خلف كجلد الأجربي.
And I stayed with people who are bad. They resemble the skin of the person who has جرب. Is that rabies or إيش الجرب يا أبو يونس؟ The skin which causes itchy skin, basically itchy skin problem. So I stayed behind in a people who are خلف, bad people. This word خلف, right? They resemble the skin of the one who is itchy. Scabies, yes, scabies.
فالخلف مذمة والخلف ليس فيه مذمة.
So the word خلف with a سكون, there is dispraise in that. But the word خلف, which means the succeeding people, those who come later on, does not necessarily there is dispraise in that, because they come later and they are following those who are before, they could be praiseworthy. But the word خلف with a سكون, it means that they are coming later and they are bad people.
فبعض الخلف صار من الخلف رجع إلى الحق.
Right. So some of the bad people, they retracted to the truth, right?
وبعضهم بقي خلفا يستحق الذم.
And some of them, they remained to be bad people, corrupt people who deserve to be dispraised.
وأشار شيخ الإسلام رحمه الله تعالى.
And شيخ الإسلام رحمه الله, he hinted
إلى ثلاثة من هؤلاء.
He hinted or pointed to three of those.
أولهم ممن أشار إليهم الشهر الثاني.
The first one that he pointed to is the person الشهرستاني.
وهذا كان على منهج.
And this he was on the methodology.
المحرفة.
Of those who give figurative meanings to the attributes, or if you want, as the Sheikh said, distorted the meanings of the attributes.
وبعد أن خاض في علومهم الباطلة.
And after he indulged himself completely in their false branches or types of knowledge.
عرف أنهم كانوا مبطلين.
He knew that they were upon falsehood.
فقال هذه الأبيات التي سمعتموها.
So he mentioned these lines of poetry that you heard.
أعد البيتين.
لعمري لقد طفت المعاهد كلها وسيرت طرفي بين تلك المعالم فلم أرى إلا واضعا كف حائر على ذقن أو قارعا سن نادم. The one he said that he toured the whole world and he went everywhere and he did not see anyone but someone who places his palm on his chin out of being confused, or one who is biting on his finger because of regret.
فعندما يعني رأى هذا الضلال رجع إلى بعض, طبعا هو لم يرجع بالكلية إنما رجع إلى بعض الحق في إمرار ألفاظ النصوص ألفاظ الصفات.
So after he indulged himself completely in that misguided knowledge, he retracted. The Sheikh said he did not retract completely, but he did retract from some of what he was saying about the attributes, the wrong things that he was saying about the attributes of Allah.
وإثبات معانيها الصحيحة.
He started passing those attributes as they have come and affirming the correct meanings of them.
ولكن أهم ما رجع عنه.
But the most important thing that he retracted from.
أنه أخذ يذم منهجه السابق.
That he started dispraising his old methodology.
ومنهج أشياخه الذين أخذ عنهم.
And the methodology of his sheikhs that he took from.
والمثال الثاني الذي ساقه أو أشار إليه الشيخ.
The second example that the sheikh mentioned.
ابن سينا المعروف.
Is ابن سينا.
المعروف بالطبيب أو الرئيس.
The famous doctor.
وهذا كان.
Chief, they call him.
وهذا كان إسماعيليا خبيثا باطنيا.
And this person he used to be from the Ismailites. He was a very corrupt person.
وبعض الفلاسفة يلقبوه المعلم الثالث.
And some of the philosophers they call him the third teacher.
يعتبرون أرسطو المعلم الأول.
They consider Aristotle the first Aristotle. Teacher. Aristotle the first teacher.
والمعلم الثاني الفارابي.
The second teacher is Al-Farabi.
والمعلم الثالث ابن سينا.
The third teacher is Ibn Sina.
وابن سينا إن ولو بقي على اعتقاده الفاسد.
Ibn Sina, although he stayed upon his corrupt belief.
ولكنه قال مقولته الأخرى التي ذكرها الشيخ.
But he said this other statement that the Sheikh mentioned.
في الأبيات التي سمعتموها.
In the lines of poetry that you heard.
سواء كانت من إنشائه.
Whether he made them himself.
أو كانت من استشهاده بهذه الأبيات لغيره.
Whether he initiated them himself or he just using them. As you know, he took them from someone else and he's using them.
اقرأها.
اللي هي نهاية
إقدام القلوب.
It says نهاية إقدام العقول عقال وأكثر سعي العالمين ضلال.
ترجمها. ترجمها.
Yes. So the end of the embarking of the intellects or the this. Training of the intellects, the end of it is a knot or a tie, and most of the labor of the world, the people, is misguided. And أرواحنا في وحشة من جسومنا وغاية دنيانا أذن ووبال. Our souls are in alienation from our bodies. And the utmost end of our life is harm and destruction. ولم نستفد من بحثنا طول عمرنا سوى أن جمعنا فيه قيل وقالوا. We did not benefit from our research all our lives except that we gathered together in it. They said and they said.
فهو ليس متيقنا على منهجه.
So he is not sure. Of what he is saying.
وليس ثابتا عليه.
And he is not really firm and fixed upon it.
ويذمه.
And he is actually dispraising it.
بينما نجد السلف.
While we find the pious predecessors.
يصرون على منهجهم.
They are insisting upon their methodology.
ويزدادون له تعلما.
and they even learn it more.
وتعليما.
And they teach it.
ويتمسكون به.
And they stick to it.
ويدعون الله عز وجل أن يميتهم عليه.
And they ask Allah عز وجل to make them die upon it.
ولا يرجعون عنه بحال من الأحوال.
And they never retract from it at all.
وأما الثالث.
As for the third one.
فهو الفخر الرازي.
The third one is الرازي.
فخر الدين الرازي.
أظن هذه الأبيات للرازي شيخنا. هذه أبيات الرازي آخر دنيانا.
لا إيش قال؟
الأول الشهر الثاني.
لقد تأملت.
والثاني اللي هو الرازي.
طيب الثاني هنا قال وهو فخر. نعم فخر الرازي نعم. أما القائل السابق.
هو ابن سينا مكتوب.
ابن سينا نعم.
أيوة.
الثالث الذي هو الفخر الرازي.
أيوة.
ماذا قال؟
اللي هو هذا.
لقد تأملت.
أيوة. He said I have examined. The philosophical statements or the philosophical methodologies and the intellectual rhetoric and the methodological or the philosophical methodologies, I did not see them that it will heal the sickness nor quench the thirst. لقد تأملت الطرق الكلامية والمناهج الفلسفية فما رأيتها تشفي عليلا ولا تروي غليلا ورأيت أقرب الطرق طريقة القرآن. I have seen the closest of the ways is the way of the Quran.
نعم إذن هو مع أنه كتب كتبا كثيرة وتعلم علوما كثيرة ولكن في نهاية الأمر وجد أن طريقة الشيخ الذين أخذ عنهم في التأويل أو في التحريف إن شئت أن تقول فهو الصحيح.
So he got involved in this too much, but then his way was the way of the giving the attributes, the figurative meanings, or if you want to describe it correctly, to say the distortion. He used to distort the meanings of the attributes.
لا تشفي عليلا.
He found that this way does not heal the sick.
ولا تروي غليلا عطشانا.
And does not quench the thirst.
وأن خير ما وجده هو طريقة السلف.
The best way he found is the way of the pious predecessors.
في إثبات الصفات.
In affirming the attributes.
بألفاظها.
With their wordings.
وكيفيتها.
And the how.
ومعانيها.
And their meanings.
وأنه لا يمكن أن يفهم ما فهمه.
And that he cannot understand.
إلا من جرب مثله.
No one can understand what he understood except those who experienced the same experience as his.
وهذا بحد ذاته خطأ.
And this in itself is wrong actually.
فلا يلزم.
It's not necessary.
لمن يريد أن يتبع الحق.
It's not necessary for the one who wants to follow the truth.
أن يجرب الباطل.
That he must experience or try the falsehood.
والله يهدي من شاء إلى الحق بإذنه.
Allah عز وجل guides whomever he wills to the truth by his permission.
نعم تفضل.
قال شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية عليه رحمة الله ويقول الآخر منهم لقد خط البحر الخضم وتركت أهل الإسلام وعلومهم وخط في الذي نهوني عنه والآن إن لم يتداركني ربي برحمته فالويل لفلان وها أنا ذا أموت على عقيدة أمي انتهى. ويقول الآخر منهم أكثر الناس شكا عند الموت أصحاب الكلام. The Sheikh al-Islam Tamiya says, another one of them says, I have indulged myself in the sea that is that has a lot of waves in it, with extensive waves in it. I have left the people of Islam and their knowledge, and I have indulged myself in that which they forbade me from. And now if Allah does not engulf me with his mercy, then woe to so and so, woe to him, that is. And here I am dying upon the belief of my mother. And this is end of quote. Another one of them says that the most people or the people that have the most doubt at the time of death are the people of philosophy or the rhetorical type of intellectual rhetoric.
ننتهي من هذين ثم
طيب تفضل.
فهذان أيضا إمامان من أئمة أهل الكلام.
These are also two leaders of the people of intellectual rhetoric.
ولكنهما رجعا إلى الحق.
They retracted to the truth. They
went في آخر حياتهما.
At the end of their lives.
ومات على منهج أهل السنة.
They died upon the methodology of أهل السنة.
وذم.
And they dispraised.
المنهج الذي كانوا عليه قبل الموت.
The methodology that they used to be upon before dying.
أولهما.
The first one of them.
أبو المعالي الجويني.
أبو المعالي الجويني.
المعروف بإمام الحرمين.
The one known as the Imam of the two حرمين.
وتوفي سنة 76 أو سنة 78 و400.
He died the year 487.
وأشهد الناس عند موته أنه رجع عن كل شيء مخالف لمنهج السلف.
Testified to the people before he died that he went back to the way of the pious predecessors.
وهذا يؤكد صحة منهج السلف.
And this shows the truthfulness of the methodology of the pious predecessors. The year 478, I said 87,
78. وأما الثاني.
The second one is.
فهو الإمام الغزالي رحمه الله تعالى.
Then that is الإمام الغزالي, may Allah have mercy on him.
وهو أشهر من الذي من شيخه الذي سبق.
And he is more famous than his sheikh that was
previous. توفي سنة 500.
He died the year 505 هجرة.
ومات على مذهب أهل الحديث.
And he died upon the methodology of the people of hadith.
حتى قالوا أنه مات والبخاري على صدره, يعني وصحيح البخاري على صدره.
To a point that they say he died while صحيح of the Imam Bukhari is on his chest.
يعني يقرأ حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم.
He died meaning he died reading the hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
فقال أن أكثر الناس شكا عند الموت.
He said that the people who have the most doubt at the time of death.
هم المؤولة.
They are the ones who are giving figurative meanings to the attributes of Allah.
وإن شئت أن تقول المحرفة.
And if you want to call them those who distorted the meanings of the attributes of Allah.
وهؤلاء عرفوا على مدى التاريخ الإسلامي.
And these are known throughout the Islamic history.
أي المحرفة والمؤولة.
Meaning the those who distorted.
بأهل الكلام.
Those who gave the attributes figurative meanings, they are known as the people of كلام, people no. of speech or philosophy or intellectual rhetoric.
هذا بعض التفصيل لهؤلاء الأئمة.
This is some of the details of some of these imams.
أئمة المتكلمين المحرفين.
The imams of the philosophers of the distorters.
سواء رجعوا إلى الحق وماتوا عليه.
Whether they retracted back to the truth and died upon it.
أو شككوا في الباطل الذي كانوا عليه.
Or at least they doubted the falsehood that they used to be upon.
بينما لم نجد.
While we do not find.
على مدى التاريخ.
Throughout the Islamic history.
أحدا من السلف.
Any one of the pious predecessors.
رجع عن منهجه.
Who retracted from his methodology.
إلى منهج الباطل.
He went to a false methodology.
أو شكك في منهجه.
Or that he doubted the methodology he was upon.
وما يذكر عن هؤلاء إن وجدوا.
And what is being mentioned about those if they existed.
فهم لم يكونوا على منهج السلف اصلا.
Then those people were not really upon the methodology of the Salaf in principle.
ولم يفهموه ولم يهضموه.
And they did not understand it nor digest it.
ولو فعلوا ذلك.
And if they did that.
لما رجعوا.
Then they will not retract.
ولذلك من الخطأ.
This is why it is a mistake.
نسبتهم إلى السلف.
That these people are referred to or attributed to the pious predecessors.
نعم تفضل.
قال شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية عليه رحمة الله ثم هؤلاء المتكلمون المخالفون للسلف إذا حقق عليهم الأمر لم يوجد عندهم من حقيقة العلم بالله وخالص المعرفة به خبر، ولم يقف من ذلك على عين ولا أثر. كيف يكون هؤلاء المحجوبون المفضولون المنقوصون المسبوقون الحيارى المتهوكون أعلم بالله وأسمائه وصفاته وأحكم في أعلم بالله وأسمائه وصفاته وأحكم في باب ذاته وآياته من السابقين الأولين من المهاجرين والأنصار والذين اتبعوهم بإحسان من ورثة الأنبياء وخلفاء الرسل وأعلام الهدى ومصابيح الدجى الذين بهم قام الكتاب وبه قاموا وبهم نطق الكتاب وبه نطقوا الذين وهبهم الله من العلم والحكمة ما برزوا به على سائر أتباع الأنبياء فضلا عن سائر الأمم الذين لا كتاب لهم وأحاطوا من حقائق المعارف وبواطن الحقائق بما لو جمعت حكمة غيرهم إليها لاستحيا من يطلب المقابلة. The Sheikh said, then those people of intellectual rhetoric, those philosophers who went against the pious predecessors, if the matter is verified regarding them, if we check them out really, completely, then you do not find with them from the realities, from the reality of knowing Allah and the true knowledge of Him, you do not find any knowledge. If they are checked out and verified, you don't find them knowledgeable of Allah. And there is nothing actually, you will not find يعني, anything at all with them. He said, how is it then when those people who are barred, who are excelled over, who are deficient, who are outraced and premiered, those who are confused and perplexed, how is it that they will be more knowledgeable of Allah, His names and attributes, and more wise about His entity and His verses? How is it that they will have more than the early, the first and the foremost from the Muhajirin and the Ansar, and those who followed them with good, those who inherited the prophets, those who succeeded or the successors of the messengers, those who are mountains of guidance and lamps of the darkness, the ones whom the book was through whom the book was established and they were established through it. With them the book has spoke and with it they have spoken. The ones whom Allah gifted with the knowledge and the wisdom, that which they have been distinct and they excelled over the rest of the followers of the prophets, let alone the rest of the nations who do not have any book, who did not receive any revelation. And they, the companions and those who followed them with good, they have encompassed of the true pieces of knowledge about Allah and the realities, the hidden realities that they have encompassed of that, that if the wisdom of other than them was all gathered together, then a person would be shy to ask to compete with them. يعني if the wisdom of everybody else was gathered together, it cannot stand. It does not have a chance to stand in front of the information that they have. أظن وقفنا
نعم.
عند هذه.
نعم. طيب.
تقفون هنا وأكمل إن شاء الله.
أشرح وتترجم مختصر. طيب يقول شيخ الإسلام رحمة الله عليه عن هؤلاء المتكلمين المخالفين للسنة.
So he says شيخ الإسلام about those philosophers who went against the Sunnah.
يصغر من أمرهم جدا.
He is belittling them very much.
وهم صغار فعلا.
And they are very small in reality.
ويعظم
and he magnifies, aggrandizes
من السلف
of the pious predecessors
ممن من السابقين الأولين من المهاجرين والأنصار والذين اتبعوهم بإحسان
the early the first and foremost of the immigrants and the supporters
وهم عظام حقا
and they are really great
لأن العظيم من عظمه الله
that is because the great person is the one whom Allah gives greatness
وعظمه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم
the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم gives him greatness
وعظمته أعماله
and also the one whose deeds have aggrandized him or made him great
فأين هؤلاء المتكلمين المتأخرين
So where are those where can they place what kind of a status would these later philosophers have
من أولئك السابقين الأولين
what kind of a status can they have compared to those early first and foremost
المشهود لهم بالخيرية
those whom Allah testified and his messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم testified to them that they are the best
وبمجرد المقارنة بينهم
and just striking or having a comparison between them
يكون خطأ
is wrong in itself to compare them
قال الشاعر
the poet said
ألم ترى أن السيف ينقص قدره
don't you see that the sword will be belittled in its status
إذا قلت إن السيف أمضى من العصا
if you say that the sword is sharper than a stick
فمقارنة السيف بالعصا
so
في الحدة
if you compare the sword to a piece of wood in terms of sharpness
ذم للسيف وليس فيه مدح للعصا
this is actually a dispraise to the sword and there is no praise in that to the stick
فيستحي الإنسان أن يقابل بين السابقين الأولين من المهاجرين والأنصار وبين هؤلاء المتكلمين الخلف
so one should be shy and ashamed to even strike a comparison between the early predecessors and those later generations of the philosophers.
ثم يواصل شيخ الإسلام في بيان هذه الحقيقة.
Then Sheikh Islam continues to clarify this reality.
التي لا دافع لها.
That there is no need. There is no nothing to lead to it.
فيقول ما تسمعون.
So he says what you will hear. قال الشيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية عليه رحمة الله ثم كيف يكون خير قرون الأمة أنقص في العلم والحكمة لا سيما العلم بالله وأحكام أسمائه وآياته من هؤلاء الأصاغر بالنسبة إليهم أم كيف يكون أفراخ المتفلسفة وأتباع الهند واليونان وورثة المجوس وورثة المجوس والمشركين وضلال اليهود والنصارى والصابئين وأشكالهم وأشباههم أعلم بالله من ورثة الأنبياء وأهل القرآن والإيمان وإنما قدمت هذه المقدمة لأن من استقرت هذه المقدمة عنده عرف طريق الهدى أينه في هذا الباب وغيره He says then how is it then that the best generation of generations of the ummah would be less in terms of knowledge and wisdom especially the knowledge of Allah and the rulings pertaining to his names and his verses how is it that there will be less in this knowledge than those who are midgets يعني very small أصاغر compared to them or how is it then that those descendants little chicks or chickens of the little chickens of the descendants of the philosophers the descendants of the philosophers and the followers of the الهند هنا يا شيخنا
فلاسفة الهند
فلاسفة the philosophers
ولكنه اختصرها تحقيرا وتصغيرا
the followers of the philosophers of India you know and the philosophers of Yunnan the Greeks and the inheritors of the Magians المجوس the fire worshippers and the inheritors of the polytheists and the misguided Jews Christians and Sabians and their likes and their similitudes how is it that they will be more knowledgeable of Allah than the inheritors of the prophets the people of the Quran and Iman he said then I made this introduction or this preface, that is because the one whom this introduction becomes firmly rooted with him, then he will know the way of guidance where it is in this regard and other than it.
نعم. هنا شيخ الإسلام رحمه الله تعالى شيخ الإسلام يصغر هؤلاء الأصاغر فيقول كيف يكون هؤلاء الذين علمهم مستقى من أنفسهم.
The Sheikh al-Islam here is belittling those small, you know, midgets basically. How is it that they will have more knowledge than the companions when their knowledge is coming from them themselves?
أو من أهوائهم.
Or from the knowledge they got it from their desires.
أو من فلاسفة المشركين.
Or the philosophers of the polytheists.
سواء كانوا من فلاسفة الهند.
Whether they are the philosophers of India.
أو فلاسفة اليونان.
The Greeks.
أو فلاسفة المجوس.
Or the philosophers of the.
أو فلاسفة عامة المشركين.
Or the polytheists.
زرادشت وبوذا وكونفوشيوس واو.
Those people that the Sheikh mentioned.
أو ضلال اليهود.
Or the misguided Jews.
الذين عندهم بواقي من علم الكتاب.
Those who have remainders of the knowledge of the book.
أو ضلال النصارى.
Or the misguided Christians.
وأشكال هؤلاء وأشباههم.
And their likes and their similitudes.
كيف يكون لهؤلاء الأصاغر الذين ورثوا علم هؤلاء الأصاغر.
How is it that those really minors in knowledge, those who inherited the knowledge from these people,
أعظم من علم ورثة الأنبياء.
How is it that their knowledge would be greater than the knowledge of those who inherited the prophets?
ونحن بينا ابتداء.
And we clarified in the beginning.
أن الأنبياء ورثوا العلم.
That the prophets they have left behind as inheritance, they left knowledge.
ولذلك نجد السلف.
This is why we find the pious predecessors
في علومهم كلها
in all the knowledge they have
ينسبونها إما
they refer the knowledge that they have they attribute it either to
إلى صريح القرآن
explicit text from the Quran
إلى صحيح السنة
or the authentic statement in the Sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم
إلى الصحيح من أقوال الصحابة
or the authentic statements of the companions
إلى الصحيح من أقوال التابعين تلاميذ الصحابة
authentic statements of the tabi'in who are the students of the companions
إلى أقوال العلماء المهديين الذين أجمعت الأمة على علمهم وفضلهم
or to the statements of the lordly scholars whom the Ummah have unanimously agreed that they are knowledgeable and that they are noble.
فهل يستوي علم هؤلاء مع علم أولئك الذين ورثوا عن الفلاسفة؟
So is the knowledge of these equal to the knowledge of those who inherited it from the philosophers?
وهذه كلها مقدمة قدمها شيخ الإسلام.
All of this is just an introduction that the Sheikh al-Islam introduced. He put in.
والمقدمة هي ملخص.
And the introduction is actually a summary.
والتفصيل سيأتي.
And the details will come.
نعم تفضل.
قال شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية عليه رحمة الله وعلم أن الضلال والتهوك إنما استولى على كثير من المتأخرين بنبذهم كتاب الله وراء ظهورهم وإعراضهم عما بعث الله به محمدا من البينات والهدى وتركهم البحث عن طريقة السابقين والتابعين والتماسهم علم معرفة الله ممن لم يعرف الله بإقراره على نفسه وبشهادة الأمة على ذلك وبدلالات كثيرة وليس غرضي واحدا معينا وإنما أصف نوع هؤلاء ونوع هؤلاء.
نعم.
شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية he continues to say after he said that he put this introduction he said that because the one who this whom this introduction is firmly rooted with him he will know the way from guidance where it is in this regard. He said you should know that misguidance and confusion has taken over most or the most of those later generation or later people. Misguidance and confusion took over them because they have abandoned the book of Allah behind their backs and them turning away from that which Allah sent Muhammad with of the clarifications and guidance. And because they left searching or following or searching for the way of the early predecessors and their followers, and because of them seeking the knowledge of knowing Allah from the one who testified against his own self that he doesn't know Allah. And also the Ummah testifies to this also, that the Ummah testified that those people don't know Allah also, and with a lot of many other proofs. My objective is not to mention one specific person or one person in specific, but rather I describe in general the type of these people and the type of those other people.
نعم. يواصل شيخ الإسلام بن تيمية رحمة الله عليه.
He continues عليه رحمة الله.
أن ضلال هؤلاء الأصاغر.
That the misguidance that happened to those little people.
أتباع الفلاسفة.
The followers of the philosophers.
لم يسلكوا طريقة السلف.
They did not tread the path of the pious predecessors.
في فهم النصوص الشرعية.
In understanding the legal texts.
وهؤلاء الذين لم يعرفوا الله تبارك وتعالى.
And those who did not know Allah عز وجل.
لا يمكن أن يقارنوا بمن عرف الله تبارك وتعالى.
They cannot compare to those who knew Allah تبارك.
بأسمائه وصفاته.
His names and attributes.
ولم يقصد شيخ الإسلام في كل هذه المقدمة التي قدمها.
And شيخ الإسلام he did not intend with all this introduction that he introduced.
والتفصيل الذي سيفصله.
And also even the detail that he will mention.
أشخاصا بأعيانهم.
He did not intend to speak about specific personalities.
إنما هو يقصد أنواعا من الناس.
Rather he speaks about types of people.
وما ذكرناه نحن من أسماء.
And what we mentioned of the names,
إنما هم رؤوس لهذه الأنواع.
They are actually the chiefs of these different types of people.
نعم سيفصل إن شاء الله في ما يلي من صفحات الرسالة.
So he will detail إن شاء الله in what comes of the pages of this treatise.
ما كان قدم له هنا.
He will detail this introduction that he introduced here.
وسنشرح هذا التفصيل إن شاء الله في المجالس القادمة.
And we will inshallah explain those details in the next sittings.
وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم والحمد لله.